Hello student, very good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think yesterday we had discussed about the Beckmann rearrangement reaction. And today also we are going to discuss the rest part of the Beckmann rearrangement reaction. And in Beckmann rearrangement reaction, generally how the Beckmann rearrangement reaction takes place, what is the starting material he has taken as a starting material is R dash, then C double bond N OH and R. This is as an oxime derivative, and that derivative is treated with acid catalyze, and we are getting R C double bond O NH then R dash. This is a general amide is formed over here, N substituted amide. This is known as a Beckmann rearrangement reaction. So now there, look at here, R and the R dash and R here, remember, look at this R group, R dash, and this hydroxyl group, they are anti to each other. Therefore Beckmann rearrangement reaction is highly stereopacific. Stereopacific means the resulting end product or the final product formed one and only one product is known as a stereopacific reaction. It is a highly stereopacific reaction. And then the migratory aptitude means the natural tendency of alkyl or the aryl group. Suppose the oxime, if there are two different substituents present in oxime derivative, for example one is a ethyl group and one is a phenyl group, or one is a methyl group and one is a, or oxime derivatives for obtained with the help of acetophenone, that derivative further treated with acid catalyze, where in a Beckmann rearrangement reaction various acid catalyzes are generally used, such as concentrated sulfuric acid, then phenyl sulfonyl chloride, silica SiO2, and most commonly used reagent in Beckmann rearrangement is a PCl5 phosphorus pentachloride, and resulting compound obtained as a N substituted amide. Here look at here the mechanism and everything we already learned in our previous lecture. When migrating group is an aryl group, aryl means aromatic compound, the electron donating substituent para methyl or para methoxy etc. strongly accelerate the rearrangement reaction, while or vice versa, when there is a electron withdrawing substituent such as para natro or para chloro etc. they strongly retard the rearrangement reaction. Retard means they decreasing the rate of the reaction. Migrating group are very slowly migrating, and hence the rate of reaction is decreased. Suddenly when there is a aromatic compound which containing as a electron withdrawing group. And then next point is the stereo PCPCT. The reaction is highly stereospecific, that is, one and only one product is obtained, the group anti with respect to oxime hydroxyl group always migrates irrespective of relative migratory aptitude of the two group attached to carbon. For an example, suppose you have a acetophenone, we know that there are pH, then C double bond N OH, here is a CH3, this type of the, when it is treated with PCl5, this group is migrating from here to here because there is a competition between these two group. One is a phenyl aryl group and one is a alkyl group, which is methyl group, and the group migrate which is present anti to the hydroxyl group of this hydroxyl group anti to pH, and therefore the resulting compound formed will be this one CH3, C double bond O, then NH, then pH. Acetanilide is formed here with the help of PCl5 or concentrated H2SO4. Phenyl group migrate to give acetanilide in case of isomer of acetophenone oxime in which phenyl group anti. The migratory group involved in this 1,2 alkyl or aryl shift migrate with retention of its configuration. Retention means suppose you are starting material has R configuration, then whenever there is a product form, it must possess the R configuration, and that type of the configuration is known as retention of configuration. Means before the reaction, whatever the configuration is present, it remains as it is. So that type of the phenomenon is known as retention of configuration. After the reaction also, the resulting compound possess that configuration as it is. The migratory group involved in this 1,2 alkyl or aryl ship migrate with retention of its configuration, and this clearly indicate that migrating group does not become completely free during the rearrangement, and thus the two steps, that is migration of the alkyl or aryl group and the breaking of nitrogen oxygen bond in the conjugate acid or ester of the oxime, are concerted. That is reaction taking place simultaneously. Means whatever the bond breaking or bond forming taking place simultaneously, and that kind of the reaction generally termed as concerted reaction. The reaction is facilitated by polar solvent and the high temperature. Remember this Beckmann reaction, the rate of reaction, the formation of the product, the rate of reaction is increases, and that reaction are accelerated by two important factor. One, if the solvent is a polar in nature, means polar solvent and the temperature is high, then that Beckmann rearrangement reaction is generally facilitated by polar solvent and the high temperature. Now let us look at one more example over here so that we can get how retention of configurations. If you start with the starting material, suppose we have here C4, H9, CH, C2, H5, then there is a enzyme double bond N, OH, and here is a methyl group, CH3, and here treated with the acid, because these reactions are generally carried out in acid medium. Here one chiral center is there. Chiral center means the carbon atom carries four different group. That carbon atoms are generally known as asymmetric carbon atom or chiral center, and that shows the maybe as a R configuration or the S configuration, R and S, they are the absolute configuration. So depending upon that, we can easily find out whether it possesses as a R configuration or a S configuration. It is a chiral center. The chiral center remains as it is because there is, even though the bond is broken between this carbon atom and this one, still there is a no change in the configuration, that retain as it is, and therefore such a kind of the reaction, Beckmann reaction, is a highly stereospecific reaction, because the group which is anti to hydroxy group should be migrate, and the resulting product obtained will be like this. So that you will be getting here CH3, C double bond O, then NH, then let's see H here, then C4H9, and here maybe as a C2H5. This chiral center remains as it. You write like this, or you can show here only C4H9, CH, C2H6, then NH, C double bond O, CH3. You can represent the product this way or this way. Both are the correct way of representing this product. Here just remember, this chiral center is attached to the nitrogen, means when it is migrating, because this group is present anti with respect to the hydroxyl group of oxime derivative, and that's why we are getting that type of the product. And suppose let us see, here we have one more example. Here let us see how we can show this retention of configuration. Let's see, the starting compound is once again R dash C double bond N OH, then R. It will be treated with PCl5. PCl5, we generally represent 5 chlorine atom which are attached to that phosphorus. Then OH is going to attack over there. One of the chlorine atom depart from this phosphorus, and you will be getting here R dash C double bond N, then O, PCl, another Cl, another Cl, and this Cl, and R group as it is. Now in the next step, there is a migration of this R, taking its bonding pair along with it. It migrate from carbon to the electron depletion center, there will be a elimination of O minus PCl4, and you will be getting here R C double bond N, then R dash, the positive charge present on that carbon atom. Now the lone pair present over the nitrogen atom, neutralizing this, and you can show the resonating structure or the mesomeric structure like this: R C triple bond N R dash, and now the positive charge shifting from carbon atom to the nitrogen atom, and this species is known as nitrilium ion, and that nitrilium ion get trapped with water. Now H2O water, and what do you get over here? After H2O, it is going to attack on that carbon atom. This positive charge get neutralized. The resulting compound form RC, then double bond over here, then R dash, then hydroxy group. This is just like as a enol form. It trying to go into as a stable one. So this hydrogen atom is shifted from here to here, that is tautomerism takes clear at an equilibrium, resulting into as a stable formation of the product NH, then R dash. So here the retention of configuration takes place. So we have got over here. So in this way we have discuss the mechanism of Beckmann rearrangement reaction with the both the way by using phosphorus chloride as well as in acid medium. This reaction, how the products are formed, that we have talked here. Now the next point we are going to discuss about the applications. What are the applications of Beckmann rearrangement reaction as far as the actual use of this Beckmann rearrangement is concerned? The most important synthetic application of Beckmann rearrangement in textile polymer industry is the preparation of epsilon caprolactam from a cyclohexanone enzyme in presence of concentrated H2SO4. Epsilon caprolactam upon alkaline polymerization gives nylon, and this is one of the most important application of that Beckmann rearrangement reaction. Now let's see in the polymer industry how it can be played important role. Let's see here the starting compound. Here generally as a raw material use, this is the structure of cyclohexanone, and when it is treated with H2NOH, this is known as a hydroxylamine, and that hydroxylamine in a acidic medium form the derivative which is known as this one. This is oxime derivative, cyclohexanone oxime derivative, you can call it as cyclohexanone oxime derivative, this one, and this derivative further treated with concentrated H2SO4, it gives this type of the compound over here, NH, then see double bond O, then this one, this is known as adjacent carbonyl group is known as alpha, beta, gamma, delta and epsilon, and therefore this is nothing but as a epsilon caprolactone, caprolactone. When amide group in the ring, that type of the species are generally referred as a lactone, and therefore it is epsilon caprolactone, and it is one of the essential and the main requirement for the synthesis of nylon when it is treated with the alkaline medium. Just use as a base, heat it here also as a heating, because this Beckmann rearrangement reaction get accelerated with the high temperature, and therefore here base catalyzed reaction, it is easily broken down that peptide bond and polymerization occurs, and we will get here double bond O, then NH, this type of the N time of, and this is known as a nylon. Nylon, there are different type of the nylon 6,6, or this one, this is one of the best application in as far as the industrial point of view is concerned. In the next one, second point, Beckmann rearrangement is used to establish the stereochemistry of the oxime as it occurs by migration of group anti with respect to hydroxyl group in oxime. The product amide obtained from Beckmann rearrangement is subjected to hydrolysis to give amine and acid, and from the products of hydrolysis of amide, the structure of the amide is determined. For example, suppose we have a oxime over here, let's see how we can get the information about what kind of the structure of amides are there. That is the second application of Beckmann rearrangement reaction. Let's see, suppose we have this one oxime R to R dash, then CO N H, then it will be treated with H plus, it gives once again the R, then CO NH, then further treated with the base, it forms R dash NH2 plus R COOH. There is amine as well as acid we are getting. This is a general reaction. How we can determine the actual structure of the amide? And once you, and as we know that, by knowing the structure of the, what kind of the amines are formed, depending upon the nature of that amine, we can easily find out what kind of the structure of amides has initially. So suppose we have a starting compound R dash C double bond N OH, it will be treated with H plus generally as a catalytic acid is used over here. Then as we know that how it can form here R dash, then C double bond N OH2 positive charge, and it is R. Now this R group is migrating along with its bonding pair of electron, and we will be getting here R C double bond N, then R dash positive charge over here. And next one, once again the lone pair can neutralize this positive charge, we will get R C triple bond N positive charge over here and R dash. This is known as a natrium ion, is known as a natrium ion, and that natrium ion get trapped with water H2O. We will get here R C OH double bond N R dash. Then that during that tautomerization, here the resulting compound form will be R C double bond O N H R dash. Then it will be treated with base, so that we will get over here acid R C double bond O OH acid, as well as R dash NH2 amine is formed, which is a basic in nature. So by using this, we can get as a this type of the compounds. So let us see some of the example over here. You know the mechanism. Now there are large number of applications. Suppose you have a starting compound is this oxime. Suppose O M E double bond O, then here may be as a CH3, not this N O H. What would be the product? If H plus is there, you will get here CH3 C double bond O, then NH, then this one. This could be the product OAB. And suppose you have another example over here, this one. Suppose you have a methyl group over here, this oxime NOH, there may be as a pH treated with the same catalyst H plus. What do you get? You will get here pH C double bond O, then NH. If once you know the mechanism, you can easily predict the product, or you can propose the mechanism. I think in this way we have discussed the details application of Beckmann rearrangement reaction in this lecture. In our next lecture, we will discuss the next rearrangement reaction, which is important one, that is called as a Beer-Villiger rearrangement reaction. And first we will discuss what are the starting material, reagent use, proposed mechanism, and what are the application of that Beer-Villiger rearrangement reaction in actual sense. That kind of the discussion we are going to discuss in our upcoming lecture. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.